Hello, everybody, and welcome to part 3 of the Pokemon Fire Red Nuzlocke. And as you can see, my original voice recording glitched when I played this, so I have to redo my voice. But I just started off this video by showing my current team. Here's Zazu. He's a docile nature. I don't know if I showed that. That docile means nothing is different. Everything is the way it's supposed to be for a good old Spearow. And he's level 13 now, and he now knows Fury Attack, which is actually a pretty good move this early in the game, but it misses a lot, so I don't know if I'll actually be using it. Then I have Sirus. Yes, I did evolve him, because I said screw it, and I decided to train a little bit anyway, because I was sick of having him in my party and couldn't do anything. And yeah, here's Vanstrom. He's a modest nature. That's a terrible nature for a Zubat in this generation, because all of his moves are physical, all of them. And modest is plus special attack, minus attack, so very bad nature for Zubat. I might not even use him because of that. I should be scrolling to my next Pokemon soon. I don't know what I was explaining at this point, but come on! There! Joey. He's no different, see? Marluxia, he evolved into Ivysaur, because he was level 14 or 15 when we ended last time, so I just thought I might as well level him up to the point of evolution. So yeah, and we are going to Mount Moon now. And I did buy repels. The mark did have repels after all. I didn't know if they did or not, and they do, so yay, they had repels. So I think at that point I was like, which way do I have to go? I went this way. And yeah, she's waiting for her friends. And we're gonna battle her, right? Forget what she had. She had Clefairy! I think I mentioned that, yeah, when I was grind training, in Mount Moon. I found lots of Clefairies, which is strange, because Clefairies are very rare. And stuff. So I was with an Encore, which I was like, I don't care about that. I peck, and then he falls in love. So, I don't like that at all. Because I'm like a bird? How are you a bird? How are you in love with a fairy thing? Whatever the heck Clefairy is. Wait, Clefairy is an alien! Remember? The one person in Pewter City said Clefairy's from the moon? Yeah. How is a bird in love with an alien? But yeah. I was at this point thinking, should I attack again? Should I? I just like, screw it, let's try again. And then I'm like, no! And then she's singing, I'm like, yep, that does it. Yeah, I'm switching now. That's just ridiculous. And the encore ended. It's not like I was gonna attack anyway. So, I switch out to Sirus now. Just because I'm pretty sure he's faster and he can do a lot. He can do that much damage. It would be sad if you can't do that much damage that's left on the Clefairy. So yeah. Yay, experience points. Yes, you did lose. So sad. Alright, and then I go back and heal, I'm pretty sure, because I didn't want to be sleeping. Yay, here we are again in Mount Moon. We are now continuing. Beware, Blue Zubat is a bloodsucker. Oh, no. Not a bloodsucker. Anything but that. So yeah, we're going to go this way, and I think I go down that ladder, because I have no idea how to get through Mount Moon. It's been a while since I've played these games. And then, as I was walking through here, I was like, yeah, this does remind me of the old games. I do remember this tunnel thingy. And then I got very mad that the repel wore off, and I was like, oh wait! These are regular repels! They run out very quickly! Unlike super repels and max repels, they don't last very long. And there's a Rocket Grunt, randomly. So, we, Team Rocket, are Pokemon gangstas! Yeah. Gangstas, huh? Alright. I guess great for you. He has a Sandshrew, and I have a Zazu. And I'm like, yeah, that's okay, ground can't hurt me. So yeah, we're good with this. And then I try Fury Attack, just for the heck of it. And it does okay damage. I could only kill it next turn if I get hit four times. So I just thought, two pecks should do it anyway. So here's my second peck, and Sandshrew survives with like one HP. I don't know how much HP that exactly, so still, it made me very angry. So yeah. Rattata! I'm like, Zazu's almost dead. I might as well switch out. I don't want to risk anything. So I go to Sirus. And yeah. I'm sorry, this is not nearly as entertaining as when I'm doing it for the first time, but... I hate... I mean, no. What was I gonna... I didn't know where I was gonna go with that sentence, but... I had to do this because my original voice recording got screwed up. And he's sending out Zubat, I'm like, I can kill Zubat on one hit, because... Confusion is super effective, and that's all I was training on in this place with Sirus. So I'm pretty sure Sirus can beat another stupid Zubat after all the amount that he's killed. So, yes, you blew it. Alright, we're going to continue, and we're going to get this item, and I'm pretty sure it's a star piece. Yeah, star piece. I'm like, wow, I went all this way just for a star piece. If this was Paper Mario, I'd be like, yay, a star piece! But no, all that's worth in this game is just money. You can just sell it. That's all the point of a star piece is. It's kind of like a nugget, except worse. Or is it? I think it's worse than a nugget, yeah. So then I go up this way, and then I'm like, ooh, there's a guy over here. What's he doing? And I think he's looking for fossils. Yeah, he's excavating for fossils, and Brock sometimes helps him. And like, yeah, that's great to know. Alright, and there's a girl over there. And, I use my repel, or... I'm using a potion, because that was almost dead, that's right. And then I'm like, wow, that animation, put it using a potion, is so stupid. It looks like they eat the potion. They do not eat the potion. A potion is a spray-type medicine. You spray it on them, and they're magically healed. That's how potions work. They don't eat them. Yeah, it's way bigger in here than I thought. Alright, yeah, she has an Oddish. Which, I'm like, yay, flying is good against grass. Yayness. But I don't kill it in one hit. So it's going to use an absorb attack. Which is not going to do much damage. So then I'm going to use Peck again and kill it. Yay. Yay, I grew a level. And then she sends up Bellsprout, the other grass type of this game. Oddish and Bellsprout are the two grass types of this game. I know in Red and Blue you can only catch one in one version and one in the other. It might be like that in this game too, because they're remakes of those games. Yeah. That was such a hard battle. What am I doing now? I think I'm looking at my team to see if I should... Oh, I'm putting Vanstrom up front! I'm gonna regret this. Yeah. I'm like, hey, why don't we see what Vanstrom can do? And, oh wait, I should put repels. I don't want to run into more Vanstroms. And... Yeah. We're walking along. La 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 la. And I was like, should I go down the ladder? Nah, I don't want to go down the ladder. I walk and I fight, and I'm gonna fight this trainer. And Vanstrom is gonna have so much fun in this battle. It's a Rattata, level 10. Just a Rattata! You wouldn't think that's bad, huh? But look at his attacks. Leech Life and Astonish are his only two attacking moves. Astonish can't hurt him because it's a ghost type move. Leech Life is a terrible attack in all ways, so I'm like, I should probably just switch, but I'm like, nah, screw it. Let's try Supersonic. And I'm able to confuse him, which is good, and it's going to hit itself on the first turn, but that's the only time it's going to hit itself, trust me. But I use Leech Life, and that's not going to do much damage, but I'm hoping that it plus the confusion would slowly kill him. But slowly killing a Rattata? Is that really necessary? Rattatas are extremely weak. I should have just been able to kill this thing in one or two hits with one of my other Pokemon. So... Yeah, this is the battle that makes me realize I should not use Vanstrom until I've actually trained him a lot more, because, yeah, he's not cutting it at all. He can confuse things, but Supersonic misses a lot. Yeah. Stuff. I don't know why I didn't skip this part. Or speed through it or anything, because I can speed through things with spacebar, but I'm not playing it this second, so I can't do that. I'm switching out. I think it said Zubat, so I'm like, oh yay, Sirus is good against Zubats. Or what? No, it's a Rattata. Why would I think it's a Zubat? I think he has two Rattatas and Zubat. That's why I think I'm thinking that. I think. Oh, yeah, I think I was worried there, because he used Hellebent. I'm like, oh, don't worry, I'll go first. And he's like, no, a quick attack! And I thought, oh, if that was a critical hit, it would have killed me. Yay, Stun Spore! In the current generation, I think he learns Poison Power, Stun Spore, and Sleep Powder all in one level. But this game, no. And then, yes, he told you Zubat. This will die in one hit. It better, or else Sirus is a failure. But I already know Sirus is not a failure, so yeah. Yay, I defeated youngster Josh. And yes, losing does stink. But not my fault, that's what you did. And I'm using a potion on Sirus, right? Yeah, why would I use it on anyone else? He's the only one who's actually hurt. Now what am I doing? I think I'm putting Zazu back up front, because I'm like, Vanstrom, you suck. I'm not using you anymore. Unless I actually train you and you're actually better. And then I'm like, oh, should I go down this ladder? Oh, let's go down the ladder. Ooh, and, ooh, water. Does it do anything? No, it doesn't do anything. It's just water. And like, ooh, another rocket grunt. What's he looking at? It's an item up here. It's a TM46 thief. He's looking at the TM for thief. That's kind of fitting, I guess. We're pulling a big job here. And then he's all alone in the middle of a random room in the cave. What job is he doing? But that's all I had to say about that. And then I'm like, ooh, Zazu can handle this. All he has is Leech Life and Astonish. No. Supersonic. Yeah, that made me very, very mad. Because I'm like, Zazu? You stupid bird? Hitting yourself in your confusion? Why do you have to do this to me? Or yourself? Or both? So I just switch, because I'm like, I'm not going to deal with this crap. I'm not sure why I go to Joey, though. Doesn't really matter. I guess I thought Sirus was getting too much attention in this episode, and we should give some love to the rat. The rat of the team. Yay, bye Zubat. Ekans! Now I think I go to Sirus. Yes, I do. Because psychic powers are powerful. Oh no, Intimidate. I don't care, Confusion is special based. Yay, super effective, but it didn't kill in one hit. I was very disappointed in Sirus for not being able to kill him in one hit. Very disappointed indeed. But that's okay. I forgive him. Player defeated Grunt. Yay, you are good. Yes, I'm good. I am very good. Mwahaha. Now I'm leaving, because I'm like, that was a waste of time. And repel steps. So, we're going to continue. We're continuing. It's a hiker throw. Oh, like, oh crap, a hiker. I should not have Zazu up front, because hikers usually have Geodudes. So I'm thinking who I should have up front. I'm like, Marluxia would work, but nah, he's the highest level. Let's use Sirus. Because somehow I'm thinking special attacks are good, because Geodudes have high defense and low special defense, so yeah. But then I forgot, oh wait, Geodudes have Rock Throw. Rock Throw could probably kill Sirus in one hit, because Rock is 4 times super effective against him. But I don't think they learn Rock Throw by level 10. I don't think, but that's okay. They don't end up using it during this battle, I can tell you that much. So they either don't know it or they were stupid. Both of those possibilities are very likely. Yeah, another Geodude. I'm so excited to face another Geodude. Woohoo. Far out, man. And using Mud Sport. Then I went on a mini rant here about why on earth does Geodude have Mud Sport? Mud Sport weakens electric moves. Electric doesn't even hurt Geodude to start with. Maybe it would be helpful in a double battle if your partner was weak to electric or something, but that's. Why would you even want to use that? But And then I think it's an Onix. I'm like, oh, I don't want to take the risk against Onix. I know I won't kill it in one hit, and Onix might know Rock Throw by this level. So, and it's level 10. I'm like, ah, Brox was 14, and I was able to kill it as a Bulbasaur. So obviously this will kill it in one hit. So, yeah, that was Marluxia's first kill as an Ivysaur. He's very proud. Yeah, and there's an item up there. I'm pretty sure it's a Moonstone. And I wearied the Repel. And yeah, that was Zubat, which I had Sirus quickly kill just to grow a level. And I learned Sleep Powder. So that's nice. So then I put Zazu back up front because he's the lowest level, other than Vanstrom, who doesn't count because I'm not using him. And yes, a Moonstone. That would be helpful if I actually had someone who evolves by Moonstone. So then I use another Repel because it ran out. That's all I needed to say. And here's another tunnel-like place with walls that are look like nothing, because they are literally nothing. And there's more water randomly coming out of the wall. I'm not sure. I really don't understand the point of that. But and there's an item up here. It is a revive. Ha! Huh, that's so helpful in a Nuzlocke challenge. Ha 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 ha. Yeah. I was much more enthusiastic when I said it the first time, but. Yeah! Little kids should be messing around with grown-ups. That's bad news. Yeah, you're real grown-up doing whatever the heck you're doing here. And yeah, Rattata level 13. That's the highest level Rattata we've seen so far. So I was like, ooh, scary rats. I use Go! Fury Attack Power! Unleash your fury! And I'm pretty sure this kills him in one hit. Because, yeah, the last one was a critical hit. Not sure if it mattered, but yeah, I hit four times. So yeah, Fury Attack is pretty good early in the game, but yeah. And I think he said Sandshrew, like, Zazu can handle Sandshrew. And then I remembered, oh wait! There was a Sandshrew earlier that he had a really hard time against. And that Fury Attack did nothing. And that's using a Defense Curl, which means I would even do less than nothing. My attacks would do so little they would even, like, heal him. No, not really, but You get the point. So then I switch out to Marluxia because I know he can kill it in one hit. I'm like, wow, critical hit. You just had to throw a critical hit in there, didn't you? Just because you could. But critical hits are part of the game, whether you like it or not. And yeah, I defeated the grunt. And he steamed! Huh! Steamed like a vegetable? Like a steamed vegetable? Like a broccoli? Steamed broccoli? Yeah. And Repel off, which made me very steamed. Ha! Like a vegetable. Or something else you can steam. I don't know what you can steam. I'm not a master chef. Yeah. Walking along this rocky road. And inside there is where that one grunt was that we fought. And here's another grunt up here. I'm like, should I switch my order of Pokemans? Like, nah, we'll be fine. And then I'm like, wow, all I want is to revive fossils and sell the Pokemon for money. Now, first of all, Team Rocket, I thought, was like an evil organization. That doesn't seem that evil to me. That kind of just seems like, I don't know, a business strategy, to me, if you ask me. There's nothing illegal about that. You find fossils, you revive them, you sell them. How is that bad? So I honestly don't know how they're portrayed as evil at this point. Because all they're after is money. What's wrong with that, going after money? I mean, I guess a little biased, I'm a business major, but I'm not like a super greedy business guy. I'm just saying, that's why you work. You have a job in life to make money. Team Rocket just happens to find this as a method to make money. What's wrong with that? If it's not hurting anyone else, then yeah. Yeah, I'll just stop ranting about that. Urgh, now I'm mad. Oh, he's so mad. He looks real mad. Not really. But yeah, now I'm gonna switch Joey up front. Yeah, I'm like, why not let Joey see some action? They're all even levels anyway, so. And then I'm like, what? A scientist? I don't remember a scientist being here. I thought it was a nerdy kid. But I guess in this game they use the scientist as the same sprite as the super nerd, which I find odd. So, yeah. And I'm like, hi, it's Miguel! Miguel is the Spanish name, Spanish version of Michael. So I'm like, huh, it's a nerdy Spanish version of me. Well, actually, that just means Spanish version of me, because I am super nerdy, so. And I poison gas, ha! Huh? Your fart missed me, ha! Huh? Yeah. Poison gas is a Grimer fart. Coughing! I'm like, nah, I don't think Joey should fight that, because coughing's a very high physical defense. And stuff. Sirus should be able to kill it in one hit. Because of super effectiveness, and they have no special defense. Yeah, boy. Like, Voltorb? Electric-type? That's good against three of my members. Which all have to be Flying-type. So yeah, now this is the point I realized where Electric and Fire are my team's two biggest weaknesses at the moment. So if I could get a Ground-type Pokemon, that would be great, because that would be able to counter both Electric and Fire. And then I was thinking, hey, wait! At some point, there's Diglett's Cave, right? I am guaranteed to get a Diglett in Diglett's Cave. So, that would be a nice addition to the team once I get to that point. So. Yeah, I now get a Fossil, and I think I pick Helix Fossil, because I feel like Omastar is a little better in this game, because he has better special attack than Kabutops, and water attacks are all special-based in this game. And that's really the only reason I picked him. Personally, I like Kabutops better as a Pokemon. I think he looks cooler, but I'm not even going to get these Pokemon for quite a long time. So even if I did want to use them, eh, why not? I just think Omastar would be more helpful. And, oh, this next part, I laugh at myself. I'm like, two black belts? A double battle? I didn't think they'd have double battles in this game, so I'm like, ah, crap, I better switch up my two flying types, Zazu and Sirus, and I better heal Zazu, because this is going to be an intense battle, right? I bet you guys who know what actually this is up here are, like, laughing at me, like, wow, you're a noob. Yeah, so I walk up there, I'm like, I'm ready to fight you, and I'm like, they're not fighting me. And I'm like, oh, they're move tutors. That guy teaches Mega Punch, and the other guy teaches Mega Kick. I'm like, sure, let's see if someone can learn Mega Punch. And then I'm like, oh wait, none of my Pokemon have arms. They either all have wings for their arms, or they have four legs. So, Mega Kick, I'm like, well, some of my legs, but... And like, nah, none of them have legs that are strong enough to be able to do a Mega Kick, apparently. So, that's okay, I'm like, eh, they're just regular normal moves, it's not a big deal. So, like, oh, wait, I probably wasted that potion then, because, yeah. Oh, we ate Roar. Roar is very pointless. So, yeah, because I healed Zazu for no reason. And there's a girl up there, I'm like, oh, I guess I can't fight her yet, because there's no way up there. But I'm like, yay, grass, new Pokemon. Let's see who it is. I hope it's not Rattata. Anybody but Rattata, please. And look, guess what it is. Another freaking Rattata. The fourth Rattata we've encountered in this wild. I was so mad, it's not even funny. I am pretty mad. And then this is another Rattata. Trust me, it was another Rattata. Then I walk one step, and guess what? Another Rattata. This game loves giving me Rattatas, huh? It just loves it. So yes, then I run to Cerulean City, and I run inside the Pokemon Center. Right? Right? Yes, I do. Alright, and when I came out, I realized I am going to have to fight someone very difficult when I go to the north. That would be my rival, Matt. And I am not ready to face him in any way. I'm pretty sure he has level 18 Pokemon. I know his starter is level 18, and I cannot fight that right now. So basically, at this point, I was like, I'm going to train some more before I go up there. I am not going to take any risks. And I don't even think I'm ready to face Misty either, because I'm pretty sure she has level 24 Pokemon. I think her star may be level 24. 21 or 24, I forget which. It's one of those. But yeah. Either way, we will see you guys next time in the next part. I hope you enjoyed this, even though my voice was an afterthought as opposed to the first recording. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed nonetheless. See y'all later, and rock on.